ever.
When Jack says he's clearing out his closet, he really means he's clearing out his closet.
And I feel like there is always this pressure coming into a new year.
We're gonna break it up in a second.
Oh my gosh, it's so neat in here, darling. So friends, I think I'm just going to start gathering. Gosh, Bob, they're back. They're back in our lives.
Oh, no.
I know.
Oh, no.
Guys, it feels like it's been forever. I just want to give you a little cheek pinch. Oh, my gosh. I don't even know how to do this anymore, Bob.
Oh, I got you. Hold on. Okay. Let me give you like a 20-second break while I fill my water.
Oh, perfect. Let me gather my thoughts. But hello, everybody. It is Dinkle here, and welcome back to my channel. I hope you all are doing super, super, super well. I don't know how I ever, it's only been a week of not picking up the camera. And I don't know how I ever went about talking to a camera like it was completely normal. It's very strange. I wish that you guys were here instead of this camera, because that would be a little less weird talking to actually people versus that. It is 11:42 right now, and I am just making breakfast. So ignore the breakfast sounds kind of coming from the sides here. How have you all been? What's been going on? Let's first address the elephant in the room. Happy freaking New Year. Happy 2022. I have personally done, let me just put my little oats in here. If anyone's wondering, I do a full cup of almond milk, or whatever other non-dairy milk we have in the fridge. Sometimes we have cashew, stuff like that, but just a cup of milk and then a half a cup of oats. And I bring the milk to a boil, and then I put my half a cup of oats in and I lower the heat, and then I just let it cook. But oh my gosh, happy 2022. These past few days, without picking up the camera, editing, or anything like that, Jack and I have made it a point to reflect on the last year and be grateful for everything, because seriously, like, without looking back at the last year, I feel like I would have just written it off as, it was like, okay, you know? There's a lot of things that we put in motion, and there's a lot of things that I thought would happen that didn't, and I'm really looking forward to getting into that at some point this week with you guys. I have a video, I think, planned for Sunday that goes a little more in depth about that sort of thing. So I'm really excited. Haven't thought about what I'm gonna say in it, so that's definitely on the list. But without looking back at it, because there were just some major things that we set out to do that just, again, did not come to fruition, I kind of looked at this past year with not a ton of like core memories, but then I was going ahead and making one of those like 2021 recaps with like all the video clips that go really fast and that trending sound that's on TikTok or Instagram Reels, the one where it's like Adele. You guys know the gist. If you don't, go over to my TikTok and check it out. It's over there. It's also, I think, on my Instagram Reels. But as I was making that, I was just, I literally caught myself just beaming. I couldn't believe all of the happy memories and things that we did indeed get to do in 2021, and how if I didn't look back at all of that stuff or just realize or think about everything that we did and all the happy times and memories, I probably would have just, again, written off 2021 as not a wash year, but just not that exciting. But looking back at everything we did, we started 2021 with freaking Disney World in Florida. I mean, come on, like, it can't be bad if you start off like that. I got to visit my brother in New Orleans, which I love doing. I love going to see him in his city and his domain. It's super, super fun going to see him there. We got to go to Lake Tahoe for Jack's 30th birthday and Seattle in that trip. We also got to go see my best friend Vanessa in Austin for my birthday. And then we also spent the summer just in Maine too, just like a good stretch of the summer, just making sure we were soaking up the Maine summer experience, because last year we didn't necessarily get that, and that was our first summer living in Maine. We definitely experienced summers in Maine before because my parents have their house up here, but not while we were living here, like not experiencing it as Maine residents ourselves. So to be able to experience a state in the season that people travel up here to experience was just so cool. So many beach days. We had so many beach days. All that to say, if you're seeing this on Monday, January 3rd, and you haven't done a reflection of your past year and the good moments, looking through pictures and all of that, I highly recommend. It doesn't have to be too intense. I know that it can be really intimidating when a new year flips to be sentimental about last year and then set goals for this year. And if you're not feeling that, if you're just like not feeling that whatsoever, you feel like you would be just forcing it versus like really just settling into it, there should be absolutely no pressure to do it. Like, that was me last year. I think I set goals, like some goals to like write down, but I know I didn't feel it, if that makes sense. And I feel like there is always this pressure coming into a new year to set goals and be ambitious and do all these things and all of that stuff. But honestly, one, you shouldn't feel pressure to do it if you're not feeling it. But two, if you're not feeling it and you're forcing it, you know deep down that like those are not things you're actually going to work towards. But going into 2021, I know I didn't necessarily feel the most inspired. I don't think anybody did. If you did, amazing, that's so good. But I think after 2020, it was really hard to think you could have any sort of control going into 2021 based on what we experienced in 2020. This year, it just felt a little different to me going into it. And by taking the break that I needed from work, from YouTube, from editing, from all of this stuff, I was able to really sit and think with myself on what is realistic but also kind of dreams that we want to accomplish this year, and really hone in on those things, which again I will share in the next coming videos. One of the things that I wanted to do is just be more organized around like kind of the videos I want to put out this year, and I've come up with a schedule in my digital planner on my new iPad, which I have to show you guys all of that too, of different videos coming up in January. What I want to do is keep the schedule that we did last year, which is Monday, Wednesday, and Sunday. It was Monday, Wednesday, Friday, but we switched it to Sunday, and I think that's really great. I love personally waking up on Sundays to watch videos and like have those in my subscription box, so I like that switch. So Monday, Wednesday, Sunday, and then two of those videos are going to be vlogs, and I think the Sunday one is going to be more of sit-down videos with more organized thoughts, things I want to talk about, things that you guys have been wondering about, all of that stuff. I think that's going to be really nice in a nice balance between just vlogs as well as sit down videos. But in the next few sit down videos, I'm gonna go over how I use my iPad to digitally plan. I wanna look at the vision board from last year versus the one for this year, which is yet to be made actually. But that brings us to today's vlog. Let's just backtrack a little bit. Needed to say hi, needed to give you a good old hug behind the camera. But today's vlog is a post-Christmas / New Year's reset of our apartment. It's time to take down the Christmas tree. It's time to take down the Christmas decor. Last year, I remember when 2020 was over, I think it was January 1st, I took down everything. Or when we were just back from Christmas break, I took down everything. I was like, time to move on, can't be dwelling. But this year, the holiday season was just so warm. It was just, it felt a lot different for us than last year. Last year had this cloud over it. This year felt like Christmas. And so I just didn't really wanna like let go of that. But here we are, January 2nd, Sunday, January 2nd, and it's time for a freaking reset. But first, we need obviously coffee, but a good hearty oatmeal breakfast. This is my absolute favorite go-to recently. So you cook up your half a cup of oats with your full cup of whatever liquid you want, water, milk, almond milk, cashew milk, whatever you want. I like almond milk the best. And you want real maple syrup and brown sugar. First, you take brown sugar, and you just get like, I don't even know, this much of a small spoon. You sprinkle it in there. I like making just plain oats first. I know you can like, there's like pre-oats and like the packaged stuff, and I'm sure that's great and all. But I like making just plain oats first and then adding sugar into it so I get to control how much there is or not. And then I love the taste of just some torn up banana on top, but you can can do blueberries or raspberries, any berries or fruit that you want. Just get your fruits in there. You take your real maple syrup, and when I say we're just going to drizzle it on top, tiniest amount, just to kind of put this flavor like on top of the bananas that didn't get the brown sugar. And here it is. I know it doesn't look like the best, but it's actually so bomb. Let me know if you guys end up trying something like this.
You could already fill them in on like how we're doing this and like.
No, actually, let's just do that just for real quick.
Okay, so rather than do everything at once, we're gonna break it up into sections.
Because
so
we like to clear out our apartment once a year.
Right.
We try not to buy things that we won't use. I try not to buy things that we won't use.
Wow.
And it's not like we don't buy things that we want. Like sometimes the use is it's just something that we want and it's fun to have.
Yeah.
But we'll use it. At the end of the day, we'll use it, whether it's something we need or something that we want. But there's a lot of stuff.
There is.
Yeah.
So we're gonna break it up. Each weekend is gonna be like a different room or mm-hmm. a different portion. So in addition to cleaning this week, I was like, I wanna tackle my closet and my desk.
Because
I'm literally going to go into the work week and it would feel so good to have just a very nice organized closet and desk.
And like your separate space.
Exactly.
Organized.
And like,
yeah.
It's kind of tricky because those spaces extend to like the drawers in the desk mm-hmm. and like the drawers out here in this hutch thingy, cleaning that up and getting organized for there.
Exactly. Usually we'll do like one weekend full of like whole apartment clear out, but it just feels intimidating, and honestly, we can do some of this other stuff, like just one room at a time in like an hour.
Yeah.
You know, for this weekend, like Jack said, he's doing a couple of his spaces while I de-decorate. So I won't be clearing out like a space in the apartment, but I will be clearing yes. out the decor.
Yes.
So eventually by the end of the first month in 2022, we'll know everything in the house and we'll like have a good sense of what we have and that it's organized and it has a spot.
It'll be really exciting. I'm kind of low-key excited.
I live for clear outs.
Yes, you do.
Big fan of clearing out things. All of this, should I show them the office first? No, this makes sense.
Like, so all of this stuff, all
was
this crap,
in his drawer.
Yeah, just stuffed in there.
I think you guys know this, but each Jack and I have like a dedicated drawer for our stuff so that we don't spill out into like everywhere around the apartment. Like this isn't just our stuff. Like I'm just talking anything daily that we go to
use. That we reach for.
Exactly. Like I've got a couple books in here that don't need to be in here. I've got my computer, which I do grab on the daily. I've got some wires for anything that I need when I'm editing videos. Mine also needs clearing out, but it's just stuff that we grab in the living space every day.
Oh yeah. I just switched out my watch band.
You did?
Because you had that extra one or whatever that came with yours.
Oh my gosh, it's so grunge.
Yeah, look at compared.
Oh my gosh, that one looks gray, but I know it was white.
And it smells too.
Ew, baby!
Okay, so anyway, all this stuff, this is a trash pile.
Okay, nice.
So this is all trash. These are the old AirPods or wire things. But
they're all
split.
Yeah, they're all split.
I saved
up the
last good one.
Okay, yeah.
Just in case. Just an extra. It is good. And then I found another iPhone charger.
Oh my gosh. Would you look at that?
We have extra iPhone chargers. We could probably pack this in my backpack.
Yeah.
Put this in the car. This is extra just in case we need to charge stuff.
I don't think we need that.
We don't need it?
No.
Okay.
No. I'm cutthroat about it.
Here are all the extra batteries. I'm going to move these into the battery drawer.
The battery drawer.
I'm going to put this back in our
cupboard. In the bookshelf.
I'm going to fix this.
Oh, it broke. All the standards.
But I got all the pieces because it was all in my drawer.
Okay.
I'm thinking I'm going to give this away.
What?
Well, it's broken.
But someone could still use it?
Someone could still use it.
Oh, okay. Then yeah, we'll give it to Goodwill. Just give it away. Okay. It's a controller.
Yeah. It's really nice.
It is a really nice
it's
one.
It's just like, this is like, you have to plug it in to use it.
That's fine. As long as it can be used. I don't want to like give trash away.
Yeah, you know? I like wireless. So
okay, yeah, that works.
This will be pretty much the only thing that goes in here for now.
That's not true. You can put
with my MacBook.
Your MacBook, and then like we put your iPad in there when we're out here as well. And then what about all the like these wires? Like where do
these? So this is for the headset when that thing comes.
Okay, yeah.
That goes there. This is gonna go into my desk. The rosary beads. I think I'm gonna put these by my bedside. This is gonna stay out here. This is in case I have something on our iPhone that we
perfect.
Want to watch.
Yep, that's
so this
good.
This goes in here. And then this can go back in the bookshelf. And I'll put the batteries in there. And then I have all my Switch games.
And then just to show you the office situation, you guys, when Jack says he's clearing, hi, Miss Allie. When Jack says he's clearing out his closet, he really means he's clearing out his closet. These are the boxes that have nothing in them, but we will confirm before we get rid of them. But Jack has a fun habit of keeping boxes, and I know from one of the last streams I did before vacation that I am not alone with the box keeping significant other. You're doing really well though, darling. Good job. So friends, I think I'm just
going to start gathering. Yeah, we're gonna leave the tree for after, but I'm just gonna start gathering anything Christmas that I see. And I'm going to put it around here like we did when we were like doing the fall decor switch with the Christmas decor, and then go get the boxes in the basement and go from there. Because I think also the boxes in the basement have regular decor that we switched out with Christmas stuff. So that'll be nice to see what we have in there. Basically, oh my gosh, I always think this is going to take longer than it actually does because it's just gathering. Like putting up decor, I think, is a lot different than gathering and just putting away decor. We're gonna go with that mentality and we're just gonna get into it.
Dry. Do you know I'm looking? And I can't help but smile. Do you know how much I love you? You put my favorite song on. I put my feet up. And we just sing along. And I can't help but feeling just loving.
I have officially gathered all the Christmas decor, but before I show you what that looks like and also before we tackle the devastating situation that is our bedroom right now because it has our Christmas presents all like strewn around and not organized at all, so that is another thing we have to do. I am in here and Jack says he finally has a closet, as he puts it, so we wanna see what that looks like.
We have a closet.
I wish I had like a solid before, but I feel like you guys can just assume what that looked like from the mess that you guys saw this morning that was all inside the closet. Are you done putting back everything that's going back?
Yes, as far as
pretty much.
Yeah.
All right, so we'll go through those boxes together.
Yes, that's kind of like the last thing.
Oh my gosh.
I have all my bins.
Wow. Oh my gosh, it's so neat in here, darling.
That's my sport bin.
Uh-huh.
That's my computer wire bin.
Uh-huh.
That's my hat. This is my gaming, like, the drawer that was out there.
Yeah.
Xbox left over.
Yep.
And then those are just a bunch of boxes.
All right, we'll look at those. And then did you go through your clothes too? I see some clothes over there.
There's some sweatshirts.
Nice.
And some shirts in the back.
Wow.
Just send that out. So I have all of this room now. All of that area is cleaned out.
Oh my gosh. There's floor on the closet. Oh my goodness gracious.
And then I cleaned out the boxes and I swept over here.
Oh wow.
And then I threw out another sweatshirt, the old white linen sweatshirt I had.
Okay. Nice, darling. Looking good, baby. Good job.